Nicely tickled away. Might just have the legs on it to go all the way. Well, it would have done without the intervention of Pramoja Wickremasinghe.
No more runs added up to the close of play. 54 for two, and I promise you it was tough going out there. You needed a very good technique to survive against Muralidharan, and Stewart had just that, so too Steve James. 15 and 20 not out respectively. Mark Butcher out for 15 and Graham Hick a duck. Four extras and 54 for two. Bowling figures, well, you don't get much more impressive than that. 18 overs, 9 maidens and 2 for 16 for Muralidharan. And nothing in the final column for anyone else, but it was very, very hard going. End of the fourth day of this Cornhill Test match. This is the way it is. England 92 behind, and don't think they're out of the woods yet. A couple of quick wickets tomorrow morning on the final day, and there will be problems again. 445 all out and 54 for two. Sri Lanka 591 all out, and just to confirm, England 92 runs behind.
An experimental treatment saves Ben's life, then the nightmares start. But are they just nightmares, or are they flashbacks of his own terrible deeds? We're in the Outer Limits in 40 minutes. An outside edge, first on BBC Two. Richie Beno has highlights of the last day at the Oval.
Sri Lanka for 591. England found it tough going at the start of their second innings. Once again, it was off-spinner Mattia Muralidharan who caused problems for the home side. In an attempt to counter the spin, Mike Butcher gave in to his own frustration, stumped by Kalavatarana a long, long way out of his crease. Hick then became Murali's next victim, LBW on the back foot and facing only his second delivery. With Alex Stewart and Steve James surviving overnight, it'll be essential that England bat for much of the day if they're to avoid defeat. Well, welcome to the highlights of the last day. It's been a real eye-opener here. A great match, great game of cricket. Played on a pitch where there's quite a bit of spin. There was not much for the pace bowlers, but plenty for the batsmen. And this is the way it looked at the start of the final day. England 92 runs behind. 445 all out and 54 for two, with James and Stewart the not-out batsmen. Sri Lanka 591, with those two wonderful innings from Jayasuriya, 213, and Aravinda De Silva, 152. Well, now everyone's thinking about what might happen out there with this pitch. Here's David Gower.
Well, the one obvious thing we're looking for this morning will be signs of turn. Muralidharan has been absolutely outstanding on this pitch over the last few days. He's the one who's turned it most. The other spinners have done very little with it. I've come to the opposite end today. We've looked at the Vauxhall end where he's been bowling most of the time, but he has bowled quite a lot of overs now towards the Pavilion end as well. And that's onto this sort of area here where in fact there is a little bit of dust around now. What happens is you'll find that when the ball hits the dustier areas, it'll grip more, it'll turn more. When the ball hits the other patches where there's a bit of extra grass, okay, it probably won't turn so much. But it's just a question of observation. He's turned it already. He'll certainly turn it more today. England's battle for most of the day is going to be against the off-spinner.
Well, that sounds as though there might be some problems there for the England side today. They have a long, tough job ahead of them. We join play with the third ball of the first over. Suresh Parreira is the bowler. Alex Stewart, the England skipper, is taking strike. No runs have been added to the overnight score.
With two men out for the lofted pull.
Doesn't matter how, whether it's by luck or a bit of a bad shot or a good ball, but you really need to get something out of the first hour.
Just had the feeling Steve James might have helped that round a bit. Nope. Perhaps not. It just seemed that it dragged it down into the dirt in front of Kalavatarana. A different technique from Steve James, slightly on the back foot there, compared with Alex Stewart's first movement, which is down the pitch with the pad. Once again, umpire Shepherd is mentioning to Mira Leedren that he's getting close to the line. Some bowlers like to be told that. Disappointment and frustration there for Murlideran.
Well, Steve James nearly got caught out, but he watched it right onto the bat, and by watching it and playing it late, that was important. He could just get the bat to the ball.
Yes! Down the ball!
And they'll get a few more as well. One for the single. And four for the overthrows.
Well, the throw was poor, it was wide, and the backing up was atrocious. Two of them. I mean, the fielder who was backing up, he was the main one to blame. He just put one hand down tentatively.
Well, looks like that was a chance. Aravinda diving away just to his right. And it did just carry to him.
Yes, not quite getting to the pitch. Almost a carbon copy of how Steve James got out in the first innings. And it was Alex Stewart this time charging down, looking to score off Aravinda da Silva. And it might have just carried. A lot of excitement in the Sri Lankan camp, but Stewart's still there. And he's certainly very tentative. No real chance of a run out there. Good running between the wickets, England. They need to tick the score over. Try and whittle down that lead, but Aravinda really is struggling. Not sure he'll complete the over. I'm thinking he'll be off.
Well, yes, he's taking his cap. It's a pretty good sign. It's only Geoffrey Boycott bowls in a cap, so one can assume that Aravinda, and I say assume, it's looking more and more obvious every step he takes that he's in some trouble. He's not going to complete the over. There are three balls left in it. That, I think, is whatever's happened there. In the dive away to his right, he might have done something to his foot. Yesterday, he, running without due care and attention, had a minor collision there with Dominic Cork and ended up hobbling away from that as well. Jaya Surya now bowling at the pavilion end, over the wicket, slow left-arm spin. Hello. Alex Stewart will pick up two here. And that's the 50 partnership between Stewart and James. Well, it's certainly been hard work for them. They've been very watchful. Of Silly Point. The change of ends has worked the magic. Steve James has gone. Straightforward chance. Pad, then bat. And straight in the hands of Jar Wardner at Silly Point. It's taken them 40 minutes, but Sri Lanka have now made the breakthrough.
I think the fortunate thing from a Sri Lankan point of view, they haven't scored a lot of runs in that time. So the pressure again back on England. Change of ends for Murali. Just turned, hit the front pad onto the bat, and a nice easy chance. Steve James not really getting a long way forward. His initial movement is back, and then when he comes forward, he only just covers the crease. So anything that turns has got the potential to hit the pad and then loop onto the bat, and that's exactly what happened there. So Murali strikes again. 10th wicket in the match.
Replaced now by Mark Ramprakash.
Chandana He's at mid-wicket, and he's probably the quickest of all the Sri Lankans. Very, very quick over the ground. They put him in a very important position because with the ball drifting onto the leg stump, of course, a lot of deliveries will be turned in that area.
Oh! Now that's the first one that's found something at the leading edge, but Alex Stewart not pushing hard at it. The ball dying off the bat.
Yes, you can see here, this is what Jayas Saria has got to do. That's hit the leading edge. He's got to vary his pace a little bit.
Beautifully played by Ram Prakash. Just waited and watched. Let the ball come onto the bat nicely and placed it perfectly.
Sure that came off the bat. There'll be a lot of excited fielders out there most of the day. But if he can bowl a little bit fuller, like this one is, he has to play across the line. There's all shouts and everybody's excited, but I don't think he hit it.
Full toss, put away through mid-wicket. Perfectly true, a lot of magic from Murali over these last few days. That's very cleverly played, just using what little pace of the ball there is from the slow bowler.
Be close, and it's a direct hit. And umpire Eddie Nichols has called for the third umpire replay. Sri Lankan fielders certainly believe that it's out, they're very confident. It's a wonderful bit of fielding.
Well, I'll say what I always say, that Alex Stewart looked in, but every time there's a direct hit, you usually find that you're in trouble as a runner. Once there's a direct hit, it's always a struggle. And I think he's struggling on his way to the dressing room. Now, that's a poor wicket to lose. Run-outs at any time are not good. But in this situation where you're trying to save the game, a run-out really is something that you should never have.
John Crawley is the new batsman, replacing Alex Stewart. And he played very well in the first innings. Well, it was always going to be a fairly risky single. Mark Ramprakash called, and Chandana is a very, very swift fielder. Beautiful throw.
Well, I think with the quality of his fielding, Chandana, I think they want to keep him on all day. Make sure that somebody stays in the dressing room. Excellent fielding, that.
Well, this one's turned and bounced quite sharply. Even Kalawitarana behind the stumps wasn't able to take that one. Oh, it's a mix-up here. They've got away with it. But I'm not sure it was a very wise move to run on what was initially a misfield. It was Chandana again, the 12th man, who backed up Ranatunga.
I think we're seeing here the result of pressure, nervousness from the two England batsmen. Oof. That throw would have been a bit lower over the top. Could have been a goner.
Well, somewhat of a breakthrough for England. Boundary to John Crawley. takes them to within one run of 100.
Yes, one run.
So the 100 up for England, loss of 4 wickets. And warm applause from another very good crowd in here at the Oval on what could be a very tense day. Well, another brilliant bit of fielding. Jai Wardner this time. Lightning reactions he has.
You don't get too many full tosses from these bowlers. When you do, you need to make the most of it, which is precisely what Mark Ramprakash has done. Not with a totally orthodox method. No advance tickets go on sale on the last days. He's got that away, but it was rather a lazy-looking stroke. The sort of thing where the ball holds up in the pitch towards the end of the match when there are a few changes in bounce. And he was more or less playing it off the back foot, and with one foot, his front foot, just a little bit raised. Just a little breeze.
The Union Jack, of course, at half-mast anniversary. Diana's death.
Don't get an easy 3 for that. Spun between bat and pad. That now will be lunch, but not a very pleasant one for John Crawley and for the England team, because they're 5 down now. Crawley bowled by Muralidharan right on the stroke of lunch for 14.
And again, the flight has done him. Really threw that one up. John Crawley stood where he was, caught with his feet on the crease, and it really did spin past the bat. And it's hit the stumps, and that's a major blow for England. The bowler's absolutely delighted, and well he might be. He's bowled superbly this morning. Great flight, lots of spin, and England are in deep trouble.
The England score now is 116 for 5, and the new batsman is Ben Holyoake. LBW, first ball after lunch. Ben Holyoake has gone. And a hat-trick in line for Mattia Muralidharan. It may well have been the top spinner. It was certainly a ball of full length, and it's 6 down.
Well, the worst possible moment for Ben Holyoake. And I'm not sure that didn't touch the inside edge of the bat from Ben Holyoake. But nonetheless, David Shepherd judging him LBW.
Dominic Cork, the new batsman. And on the hat-trick. Now then, an interesting moment for Dominic Cork. The non-striker's end, Mark Ramprakash, is 16. This is the hat-trick ball. No ball. Ball in the full toss. Well, there we are. Everyone can settle down now. Chaos. Absolute chaos. Just over the head of Lolita in that square leg. Dominic Cork is off the mark. End of the over.
Well, there's a lot of very tense people watching this match. Dominic Cork would have been quite tense seeing that ball in the air. It only just got over Murali's leap into the air.
Shouts there, and with full justification as well, because another wicket has gone down. Dominic Cork, perhaps the back of the bat, caught by Kalavitarana off Muralidharan for 8, attempting the sweep and sweeping with the spin. ...200 test match wickets for Muralidharan.
Well, Ian Salisbury's got some work to do. He hasn't started terribly well. Both deliveries have struck the inside edge of the bat.
LBW. 120 for 8 now. Salisbury goes for duck. LBW to Muralidharan.
Well, it's turning into a bit of a procession. Umpire David Shepherd feeling as though that's straight enough to be given out. Turned an awful long way. And the keeper's dancing down the leg side. He did have malice to come back into line with the stumps before he started to appeal.
Darren Goff. Very happy fans out there. Most of them are Sri Lankan fans.
Still 15 runs to go to wipe off the deficit, so Sri Lanka will be very keen to try and take these 2 wickets before that happens. Well, round the wicket now for Muralidharan. Change of guard for Ramprakash. Big appeal. Umpire Shepherd is not interested. The Sri Lankans are not happy. Huge appeal. And they reckon he might have got an inside edge. It's a great catch, or a take, I should say. Whether it's hit the inside edge, very difficult for the umpire to tell. Well, it looks like a little inside edge there.
Now that was a batting pad, I think, but it just didn't carry. It went down quickly, it didn't loop up in the air. It's going to be slow going. Doesn't matter about that. I mean, England are in a very difficult situation.
There are plenty of viewpoints near this Kennington Oval. What about you, Chris? I think I'd rather pay to get in, to be honest. We sat on that roof.
Who was that?
Enthusiastic appeal. completely ignored by Eddie Nichols.
Well, this one turned and turned very big. Struck Darren Goff on the back leg.
No ball calls, it's through everyone. That'll be entered into the scorebooks as four no balls. Straight through the legs of Kalavitarana. That's into space. Lovely piece of fielding yet again, and Eddie Nichols is going to opt for the assistance of the third umpire. Would have been a leg by, or will be a leg by, if Darren Goff is adjudged in. He seems confident enough. I think he's probably made it.
Yes, I don't think the Sri Lankans are jumping around quite as much as they were when Alex Stewart was run out. Chandana again is the fielder. And it's another lovely bit of fielding. Good throw on the run, but Darren Goff is home.
No one's going to chase that. Well, this could be a good contest. I think it's going to be neck and neck. Aravinda, I think his pride kicked in there, because Jaya Wardner, I think it was, who was, had ripped the helmet off at Silly Point. That's caused a bit of pain now for the keeper, Kalavitarana. Might just have flicked a pad on the way through onto his cheekbone or jawbone.
Well, he has for some time worn a helmet. He's not wearing it on this occasion.
Oh, he's back in position. Oh, nicely played. Very deft little fine sweep shot. Sri Lanka had to bat again, as England's going to credit the first time in a long, long time.
Well, he's given it as a leg by, but it's not that far away from the gloves. So England go to 150. Just four runs ahead.
That's a good shot. Roger Vikramasinghe just dropped a fraction short and wide. And that has hit the ground with his bat so hard.
And just watch the bowler here. Everybody behind the stumps is jumping up and down. Aravinda De Silva, very late to join in the appeal. Very, very late. It's a real lob ball here, tempting Darren Goff, the right thing to do. He couldn't resist it, but he's hit the ground very hard and not the ball.
And that's a lovely shot. Mark Ramprakash taking advantage of a very full half volley from Dharmasena. No one out at deep mid-wicket. And four more runs to the England lead, which now gets to 20.
All those runs are valuable. Runs. That's gone. That's inside edge onto the pad. Ramprakash goes, and now it
looks for all the world like a Sri Lankan victory. Ramprakash out for 42, another good innings from him.
Angus Fraser is the last man in. And Muralitharan bowling around the wicket, made it turn, pitched it up, little inside edge, bat and pad. And that's almost a perfect dismissal.
He'd be trying to play four and give Angus Fraser only one to face. Bowl him. Bowl him behind his pads. I suspect that might have been the leg break. Because it was either that or the top spinner. And it was very well bowled if it was a leggy coming in from the rough outside the right-hander's leg stump. Made an awful clatter.
Well, there certainly was a clatter. That's nothing to the noise made by the Sri Lankan fielders now that they've bowled out England for 181. 30 extras there. Angus Fraser remained not out naught. Gough out for 15 and bowl behind his pads. Now the bowling figures for Sri Lanka. There's one run out, string of noughts in the column on the right-hand side, and Muralitharan 54.2 overs, 27 maidens, and 9 for 65. Fantastic performance, and that's reflected in the match and the way it went. England 445 and 181, Sri Lanka 591 all out. And Sri Lanka now need 36 to win. We're going to join it with the first ball. It's Angus Fraser. He's bowling to Sunit Jayasuriya. And Darren Gough is not on the field. He's injured a toe.
Not so much whether they'll get them as when they'll get them.
Don't really think you're going to stop Sri Lanka from getting the target.
Nicely struck, and four runs. The one thing that Jayasuriya is good at is shots. That's wonderful. Six runs. Well, this is a great shot. Jayasuriya deciding that he's not going to muck around here. One bounce over extra cover, four more runs. I didn't realise the Sri Lankans are flying out tonight. But brilliant stuff.
That's a fierce hit. You don't see too many square cuts for six. Not on a big ground like the Oval. Both feet off the ground. They're the most remarkable stroke. And there it is. The winning runs for Sri Lanka. And it is a splendid victory. Arjuna Ranatunga won the toss, put England in. They made over 400 and still Sri Lanka won. That is a really good win, a top-class victory.
And that's the way it all finished. Sri Lanka winning by 10 wickets, their first ever victory in a test match in England. A wonderful effort. England 445 and 181 all out were beaten by Sri Lanka 591 and 37 for no wicket. And the Cornhill man of the match, Muthiah Muralitharan, and a sensational performance from him, the fifth best figures in Test match cricket in the history of the game. Wonderful performance. And at the end of proceedings, David Gower talked with the two captains.
Arjuna, you've made history today here, winning the first Test match for Sri Lanka in England. You must be a very, very happy man.
Yeah, that's one of the ambitions I had after the World Cup, and this will be my, for sure, this will be the last time I will captain in England. And it's good to win a Test match here.
It's interesting that the tour started so slowly for you. The early games, the warm-up games, didn't show that much promise. And yet what you've done is you've peaked at the right time. You won the Emirates Trophy first. You've come to this Test match chock full of confidence, and you've played wonderful cricket.
Yeah, David, we started very badly. We lost the first county game by 2 days. And then we worked very hard. Like, we went to the nets, we knew what went wrong. And the whole team, starting from the management, we stick together and we said, this can't be done. And we worked very hard on our training, including fitness and bowling and batting. Then suddenly everything came right.
Now, one of the things that we've talked about a lot over the last 4 or 5 days, certainly the first 3 days, was your decision at the start of the match, having won the toss. You looked up, said there's a bit of overcast cloud cover, a little bit of moisture, you thought you stuck England in. And we're all saying, how can you do that? The pitch is dry, you've got spinners who are going to take wickets late in the game. Now, of course, we have to apologise to you.
It's like this, David. We have to play for our strength rather than the other issues. That's what I have been doing that. Like, even in the World Cup, we chased. That's the first time a side chased runs. And we know that Murali is a key man for us. And we wanted Murali to have a break in between. That's the other reason that we wanted England to bat at the start. And I thought I have played 16 years of cricket and I have seen a little bit of wickets and have taken so many decisions. I think it's not too bad, actually.
But how confident at that stage were you that you'd only have 36 to chase?
We knew that it won't be very difficult, especially with Sanath. And we promoted Kalu to bat at number 3, but I think it's good to see the two openers finish the game.
Now, what about the men who made the runs for you, Sanath and Aravinda?
Yeah, a lot of people were talking about Sanath when he had a bad run at the start, and I was not bothered about it because I knew that Sanath is a top player and Aravind is a top player. They will be coming back at the important times. So I think Sanath peaked at the important time. And all the others, like when it comes to the one days, Atapattu, Kalvitarna, everyone batted very well and then came to the test matches and Aravind and Sanath batted for us.
Well, if one man gets 200, one man gets 150, you've broken the back of a big total. But you still had to bowl England out twice and it seems you only needed one man. Is that the best you've seen in bowl?
Yeah, I think so, especially on a track like this, especially bowling at the first day. And he's still, we know that he can turn anywhere in the world, but he was really impressed and the way he was turning and he got the odd bounce. That's where he used to take a lot of wickets and I'm really pleased for him.
As a captain though, is your only problem that every now and again you can't get the ball out of his hand?
No, what I do when I feel someone is getting no to him or getting batting better for him, then suddenly I put a change and come bring him back after 1 over, 2 overs. And even with the new ball, we just wanted to get a ball in with a little hard on. That's the main reason we just bought two fast bowlers to go for 2 overs and got Murali back once again.
It certainly works. And I suppose next time you'd like to come back here and play a slightly longer series.
I hope so. Now it's ideal time for us to get three or five test series, at least three. I will be satisfied with three rather than five. And I hope that we will get it in the future.
All right, well, very well played. Congratulations. Make the most of it. Enjoy it.
Thank you, David.
Now, Alec. Congratulations to Arjuna. Alec, where does this leave England at this stage?
Well, we've had a good summer. Obviously, at Headingley, everyone was very happy. I'll be honest, it's just taken a little bit of gloss off the summer. But we've obviously got a very busy winter ahead of us.
Yes, I mean, it's sort of down to earth with a bump, isn't it?
Yeah, I think, you know, the conditions that were provided, Sri Lanka would have been very happy with them. And I thought they played magnificently and obviously deserved to win.
Even so, it was a good pitch. Did you have the feeling you should have survived on there, should have got a draw out of it?
Yeah, possibly. I mean, Murali bowled out of his skin. You know, tremendous effort. If someone takes those number of wickets in a game, you are going to struggle. I say, if someone got 150, someone else got 200, you are up against it. But full credit to Sri Lanka.
Now, we've been watching him from the safe position in a commentary box and not having to go down in the middle. What's it actually like to bat against him?
Very difficult. You know, you can never get on top of him. A lot of spinners you can use your feet to or work around. But to be honest, with him, he's something special. Sakla Mushtaq, who plays for Surrey here, I think is a tremendous bowler. But this fella's in a different league.
Is it just that he turns the ball that much more than any other off-break bowler?
Yeah, I mean, he spins it amazingly. But he has a lot of variation. He can bowl a leg spinner, bowls another ball that goes away from you, and a ball that bounces as well. And you bowl all them, you've got a chance of doing well.
OK, as you say, it's taken the gloss off the season a bit. Now, what about your future plans, the next plans, i.e. the Ashes in Australia?
Yeah, certainly looking forward to that. The side will be announced, I think, within the next day or so. A couple of hard decisions to be made. And then we'll have a two-week break or whatever, and then we're off at the end of October for what I hope will be a successful campaign.
Alec, thanks very much. We wish you well in Australia.
Thanks, David. Thank you.
David Gower there with Arjuna Ranatunga and Alex Stewart. And that's the end of our Test Match Cricket for the summer. It has been a great summer, but we still have a match coming up, the NatWest Trophy Final, Derbyshire and Lancashire from Lords. And that's Saturday, the 5th of September, live coverage on BBC Sport. Now that I can tell you, this has been a great season. This was a nice way to finish it. And we're going to leave you with the Sri Lankan supporters and with the team as well and their celebrations. Absolutely magnificent they were, and they're a very happy lot. And I want to show you one other thing as we go, and that is Sanad Jayasuriya smashing that six over point. You don't see much like that, but I reckon this is just the thing that exemplifies the way they play their cricket.